Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to the third video of the Healthy Girl Summer Series. I don't know if you can tell right now, probably not, but it is pouring rain behind me. And at first I was like, oh no, like it was nice and sunny when I started getting ready and I was like, I'm gonna film, it's gonna be good lighting. And then it got super gloomy and then it just started like downpouring. And I was like, this is gonna ruin the video. But then I remembered today's video is literally about hydration, and what better way to talk about hydration than to have pouring rain behind me. And this is actually really good. We had like really, really dry weather here in Winnipeg. So this hydration is actually really nice for the earth. And today we're gonna talk about hydration for our bodies. How can you have a healthy girl summer without hydration? You can't. Hydration is so important for literally every single aspect of our bodies, for our physical and for our emotional well-being. Yeah, emotional well-being does have to do with hydration. Water is so important to living a happy and healthy life. We can't live without it. Like, our bodies literally cannot live without it. Although our bodies can live on limited supplies of it, we function at our best when we are hydrated and our bodies are getting as much water as they need. I really wanted to share like some super simple tips. How many I got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 super simple tips that I actually use to get myself to drink more water, because that is something that I was constantly working on. I wasn't drinking enough water and I knew that my body needed more, but just simply trying to remind yourself all day to drink water is not the easiest. So I came up with little tips that I use. So I figured I would share them with you so you can implement them into your routines as well. The first tip that I use every single day to staying more hydrated is to have a big cup of water before my morning coffee. Now, I know that everybody drinks coffee in the morning, but a lot of us do use it as our little like wake up sign. It's usually one of the first things that we do in our morning routines, but it's actually dehydrating to our body to put caffeine in it as soon as we wake up, because when we sleep, our bodies lose water and so we need to rehydrate. So a thing that I've started and a rule that I've made for myself is I drink one big glass of room temperature water every single morning before I drink my coffee. And then I honestly feel a lot better because I feel hydrated and I enjoy my coffee. So I'm not, you know, downing my coffee because I feel like I need to replenish my body. I've already done that with the water and I'm enjoying my coffee. I'm sipping on it slower and I'm feeling the effects of the coffee a lot more. You can either add lemon water, so you can have lemon water and add some lemon to it, or you can just have plain water. I just use room temperature Brita water and it works for me. So make sure you're drinking one big cup of water before your morning coffee. My second tip is to find a glass, a jug, a water bottle that you love. It's really weird how it works, but psychologically, if you love what you're using to drink water out of, you're gonna wanna drink more water out of it. So I actually love really massive mason jars. I love the look of them, the aesthetic. I love that they can hold a lot of water so I don't have to refill it very often. So for me, it's massive mason jars. And then I have like a cute pink water bottle that I just bring with me out and about. But find things that work for you, or even just like find a favorite cup within your house. I know for even my coffees and my tea, like I have my favorite tea cup, I have my favorite coffee cup, like that's just how it works. And for me, I find that it's so much easier to drink when I have like a favorite cup. It's weird, but it works. It doesn't have to be fancy. Go to a random store and just find something cute that you like. I even like straws, so I find it's easier for me to just drink from a straw. So I like a cute, colorful straw. Just find things that make you happy, make you want to drink your water. It sounds really silly, but I'm telling you, it works. My third tip is to bring water with you every single time you leave the house. There are certain things that we need with us before we leave a house. Keys, wallet, a snack, lots of things, and make sure that water is one of them. I do not leave my house without my water bottle, because when I'm on the go, I am sometimes go, 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 and I don't even notice that I'm thirsty, or I'm thirsty, but I'm like, oh, I don't want to pull over and buy something, so I'm just gonna like wait till I get home. But that's not good, because sometimes you can be out all day long, or even on a really hot day, you just need that water. And chances are that if you're gonna go through a drive-thru, you're probably gonna get an iced coffee, or you're probably gonna get some sort of like a slushy drink, or you're gonna get some sort of like pop if you're going through like McDonald's or something. You're not gonna think to get a water. So bring a water with you, that way you always have it on hand, that way you can just even sip on it and just have it all day. You're rehydrating and you have that reminder when you see it sitting there in your, I was gonna say glove box, but it's not a glove box, in your cup holder. When you see it sitting there in your cup holder, you're going to remember to drink it and you're gonna drink it a lot more. Just make it a rule, leave with your wallet, leave with your keys, leave with a snack, and leave with a water bottle. My fourth tip is to make your water more fun. So if you are someone that doesn't like the taste of plain water, or you wanna even just add little extra things to your water to make it even better for you, I highly recommend making fruit water. So just literally putting fruits into your water and then sipping on them and then having the fruit as you have your water. You can do this in so many different ways. You can just cut up fresh fruit, throw it in your water, like if you're having it in a mason jar or in a water bottle, like that, just to add some extra flavor to it. You can switch it up and try different fruits so you have a variety of different flavors. If you are someone who doesn't want to constantly be putting fresh fruit in your water, you can totally just make a massive jug of water and then add fruits into it. And then that way, if you leave it overnight, then the fruits will add extra flavor to your water and it'll be ready to go. And another thing that I've recently started doing is actually making fruity ice cubes. So I love doing this with lemons and limes. So I'll squeeze some fresh lemon juice and lime juice into an ice cube tray, freeze it, and then I have like lemon and lime ice cubes. Now be careful, because if you do a full ice cube, they are very, very strong. So you'll only need like one or two to make a very flavored drink. So be careful not to overdo it with the lemon and the lime, but you can really do this with like orange juice too. You can squeeze any sort of fresh fruit juice into ice cubes, freeze it, and then you can just pop them in and it's easy. All you do is pop an ice cube into your water and boom, you've got some flavor. And my last tip, see, these are easy, these are quick, these are super simple. So my last tip for keeping your body hydrated, this is actually something that I came across super recently, and I don't know if I've been living under a rock, but to have coconut water. Coconut water, although it is an acquired taste, is actually really good for you, and it's filled with lots of nutrients, one of those being electrolytes, which replenishes the electrolytes in your body, helping you feel more hydrated and have more energy. So coconut water, I know, like I said, it's an acquired taste, and the solution for that is you can buy flavored coconut water. So for example, regular coconut water, for me, I can tolerate it, but I don't love it, I don't crave it, versus like pineapple flavored coconut water, it tastes amazing. It just tastes like watered down pineapple juice, and it's so good. So coconut water, like I said, has a lot of electrolytes, and that helps to prevent dehydration. So it is recommended that like people who work out really hard or really intensely, or during the summer months, if you're doing an outdoor activity that is going to make you sweat a lot or work your body a lot, it is recommended to replenish the electrolytes in your body. So rather than reaching for an energy drink, which does have a lot of sugar, you can reach for something like coconut water, which has significantly less sugar. Now be careful, don't rely on coconut water as your only source of hydration, because coconut water does also have potassium in it. And if you drink too much coconut water, you'll going to have elevated levels of potassium, which could also cause health problems. So in moderation, I always have just like a big jug of coconut water in the fridge, and I'll just sip on it, or I'll have it here and there when I feel like I need a lot of extra hydration. Those are just the tips that I've been going by to help me drink a lot more water, and I can seriously say that they have definitely helped. So if you like these tips, please do give this video a thumbs up. It really helps to support me and my channel. Really hope that you enjoyed it. Make sure you stay hydrated, my friends, just like the earth right now is hydrating our dried up city. Make sure you hydrate your bodies as well. But that is all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Know yourself, know your body, and until next time.